So let me explain what's happened with Giancarlo Stanton.
It's the game of baseball.
He had a biceps problem. Then he had a shoulder problem. Then when you're on the IL, you then get put on a rehab assignment, which starts the clock at 20 days. And at the end of those 20 days, you have to be back in the big leagues. So he was on a rehab assignment. I guess he got hit somewhere around the knee in a game. Now it's swelling up. He's been put back on the IL. Never that he didn't really leave the IL, but he's taken off the rehab stint, which means the clock can be reset when he wants to go rehab again. So now he has left calf tightness. Every Yankee fan that's listening to this show right now, when I said essentially that Stanton had a setback, they didn't go, oh, no.
No.
Nobody cares right now. I mean, they want those players back because that completes what this team is doing, because they should be even better with those players. But right. There's no sadness where, you know, when Andujar went down, everybody felt sorry for the kid, but because Urshela's doing so well, people didn't go crazy over it.
And the amazing thing, Michael, and maybe this is the conversation that we had earlier a couple of days ago about just how many bad teams there are. I'm just trying to look at the stretch where the Yankees should be concerned. You know, the rest of this month, they're finishing up with the Orioles. Then you go to Kansas City. San Diego's not a bad team, but they're not a great team by any stretch. And then the Red Sox series, that's the homestand. Now, the Red Sox, I think, are starting to find themselves. It's a four-game set. That's pretty good. Day off, three against Toronto, not good. At Cleveland, that's a good team. And then you got the Mets under 500. You got the White Sox, Rays again.
A lot of bad teams.
Astros for four, which is home. That's a tough test. But then it's back to the Blue Jays again. Red Sox. Really, unless I see Boston or if I see Houston, maybe Tampa, the Yankees are just better than all these teams, even as presently constituted. They're just better. I'm not really seeing, Michael, where you go, we got to get him back in time, because we got to get him back coming out of the All-Star break, because, oh, my God, the schedule's going to get tough. Is it? After the All-Star break, a homestand, three against Toronto, four against Tampa, three against Colorado. You know, all right, Tampa, four against Tampa, but still, Colorado, Toronto. You got the Diamondbacks again at home. That could be tough. Really, Michael, there's only like four or five teams you really got to concern yourself with. They may not need any of these guys back until we get to the playoffs.
Yeah, that's why there's no urgency. Now, here's a bit of positive news from Brian Hoke of MLB, who covers the Yankees. Luis Severino could resume playing catch when the team returns to New York Monday. That's the one guy that he comes back. When would you just assume that Paxton's going to come back?
Right.
That completes the puzzle. So they think he could be back July 1st, July 7th, something like that. Because right around that time, Domingo Germán, who's now 9-1, is going to be closing in on his innings limit. So I think the most he's ever pitched is 120. The formula is never push a guy more than 40 innings more than he was. So would they get him to 160? It's going to be tough to take him out of that rotation. This guy could start the All-Star game.
That's why you haven't missed Severino at all. Really, you haven't missed anybody. Can you come up with a compelling argument that their record would be better if everybody was healthy?
No.
I mean, what do you expect? I mean, this has been good.
It's been otherworldly, really.